Functional Neurological Disorder, better known as FND. So I used to be a professional dancer. I danced professionally for over 10 years. I traveled everywhere doing it, which is where I met Candice, who is also a professional dancer. And we moved to England together and recently got married. And then we went on a gorgeous honeymoon, had the best time ever. And then we came back, and that's when it all started. So being a dancer, it's quite common to have an injury or a bad joint. Mine was always my hip. But when I got back from our honeymoon, my hip got much worse. And it got so bad that I started dragging my foot. And within a day, it got much worse and I ended up in hospital. My body started shaking, but shaking uncontrollably. It would appear to somebody who was looking at me that I was having a seizure. The doctor would ask me to lift my leg off the bed and I just couldn't. I couldn't do anything. And I went from being this physically very able person to being somebody who couldn't do anything or go anywhere without assistance. And it was very scary. I then went through 3 weeks of testing, vigorous tests, and everything came back clear. Every single test, they kept telling me I'm incredibly healthy, which was more frustrating than anything. To be in such a way where you can't walk, and you're in incredible amounts of pain, you can't feel your legs, and yet they're telling you that you're healthy. At that point, I got referred to a movement specialist who looked at me, did a few tests, and right away could see that it was functional neurological disorder. So the best thing I heard from the movement specialist is he said I would probably be able to walk again, and I took that and I ran with it. When I found out there's nothing wrong with my brain, there's nothing wrong with my body, they're just not talking to each other, I was just very determined. So I started doing physio. At the very beginning, I could move my right foot along, but my left foot was getting moved by the physio, and then eventually I could kind of drag both feet along. And my walking had all sorts of ups and downs. It had from trying to go up on my toes to walking kind of like I was on the moon, to not having my walker kind of bouncing off from one wall to the other wall, quite out of control. I then got referred to Mount Vernon, which is a neurological rehab unit, and I had an amazing physiotherapist named Lisa, who couldn't thank enough for everything she's done. She would set me up obstacle courses, all kinds of things. She would give me water glasses that were completely filled, even though I had tremors and I could barely walk, and say, walk to the other side of the room, don't spill any water. And she would give me trays of marbles to carry and not spill. She'd have me going in and out of cones and throwing bean bags. She would throw balls at me, she would do all kinds of things, and it seemed like the more I did at the same time, the more I could do, and the more I could walk, and the more regular my movement became. I started getting better really quickly. One of the hard parts was I really wanted to be able to walk upstairs. I would get to the stairs and I kind of hit the stair with my foot, and I couldn't quite get my foot high enough to step up the stair. So we worked on that a lot, and eventually I managed to not only get my foot up onto one stair, but to walk up all the stairs. My tremors were quite hard in the way that my head kind of wouldn't stop moving. I would constantly kind of shake my head no or throw my head back, which really hurt. And Lisa would do things like put things on my head and to balance on my head, and I could kind of control it and more learn how to stop moving my head. And physio was tough, but it definitely was good. It got me through. She was just incredible, and I couldn't thank her enough for everything she's done for me.
I did so well at Mount Vernon that they let me out, and I even got out just in time for Christmas.
So now I'm hoping that I can finally take my daughter out for a walk. I'm not about to say that I'm back to the old me. I still have my challenges, and even if I was, I don't think you can go through something like that and not be changed. I do take a lot of tablets to help with my symptoms, but all in all, I'm good. Which makes me remember back when I was in the hospital and I found out that I had functional neurological disorder, and I went online and I just felt very hopeless, and I just really want to say that it's not easy, it's hard, but it's not impossible. Anyone who has been diagnosed with FND, I know it's really, really scary, and there's not a lot of information, there's not a lot of people saying I have it and I've got through it, and I just want to make this video to say it is okay and you can get through it and you can get better, and at the end of it you'll realize how strong you really are.